number two for this. You guys got yeah. pressure with everybody else. What's the look for this year?
Well, obviously, this is huge for us, especially with so many new faces. The additions that we're making, we've got a lot of them here. And so this is an invaluable opportunity. And this group has me really excited, as excited as I've been since I've been here in terms of the makeup, the attitude, the chemistry. I think it's been tremendous so far. So something that we obviously want to continue to build on as we move through the summer.
Last summer, your big emphasis was defense here in these summer practices. Is that still
a... we're still early in it, and right now we've probably spent... We're just trying to get guys acclimated off to some of our terminology. It's going to be a little bit slower process with this group because we have so many new guys. The teaching's got to take place at a little bit slower level for the most part. So it's a little bit of both. You know, we've got to get them caught up on both ends of the floor with some of our terminology and just, you know, teaching aspects.
So many new guys, and how much do you kind of rely on the guys who've been here, like Pittman and guys like that?
A lot. You know, Elijah, you know, and we talk about him being here. He was here for, he had a great junior year as a transfer, and he's had a great offseason. He wasn't able to come last summer because he had to finish up academics, so he's probably benefited as much as any new guy going through our offseason, our development program from the spring into the summer. His body's changed. You know, he's gotten stronger, bigger. Now he's working on weaknesses in his game that I think is just invaluable. And but we need, you know, he's been a really good leader. And Bao's been a terrific leader. You know, he's banged up right now. Had minor surgery last week just to clean up some stuff in his knee. Be back hopefully next week or so. But he's been a really good leader. And then, you know, I put some onus on some of the young kids to lead. You know, and Manning and Boykins, who've been around a little bit, and Campbell, they know the deal now. So.
Speaking of Manning and Campbell, those guys got to, you know, got to go to other countries, experience different cultures, get a sense of what life is like outside of Marshall University a little bit.
And play
basketball,
games.
Yeah, oh, by the way. But what's the best benefit for those guys
of
getting
to do that? It is a multi-dimensional opportunity when they go. From as basketball, selfishly, they get an opportunity to practice and or play, you know, especially for JP. We needed to get him some games because one thing he lacks is game experience. So it was, you know, that was invaluable, and Tamron played really well as well. But it's also a service mission. You know what I mean? They're giving back on those, you know, on those trips to the respective communities that they visit and spend time with, and then they're also learning. You know, I think it's educationally. I don't know if JP Campbell ever thought he'd go to China in his life. You know, he's already been, or Tamron go to Dominican and do some of the service opportunities that they were able to do. That was, I think, it was really a great opportunity for those two guys.
You ever get worried hearing, you know, Tamron talking about they rode motorcycles and scooters. They didn't walk anywhere.
Yeah.
And then JP said he lost a little bit of weight because he didn't like Chinese food.
Yeah, he didn't eat much. But yeah, that was okay. I didn't mind that with JP. But, you know, they've got to try some different things. You know, getting around different means of transportation. He obviously, hopefully, he used good judgment.
I was talking to Kareem. He said that you had said to them that these next few weeks don't have to be just good; they have to be great. How, especially with all the new faces, new blood. How important?
Yeah, the new faces. That's gone now. I mean, they're here. So you know, now it's our job as coaches and, you know, to acclimate everybody. And the process has begun. I think the one thing lost in this whole thing has been how early those three JC kids got here. That was as early as we've ever been, and that's why we got to take advantage of it. Obviously, we had the three guys sitting out, Gord, and then the two academic guys, Taylor and Kareem. They were already on camp, you know, so the process is, you know, it's already been in motion. We've had I told them yesterday, I thought we've had a very good, if you had to quote it, you know, if we had a very good first half of our summer, and these next 5 to 6 weeks have to be great. And that starts with everybody and just kind of going to another level, especially guys like Pittman, some of our older guys. And you know, the process has to be accelerated for some of these guys because, you know, these guys are old. You know, there's no true freshman amongst this group. You know what I mean? We'll have two freshmen in Taylor and Kareem on paper, but, you know, they obviously
a little bit
older, and they've been on campus for a year. You know, Gord obviously been on college campus for 2 years, and then the three JC kids aren't high school guys, and we're going to rely on those guys, a lot of those guys to contribute right away, and they knew that in the recruiting process. But this group, you know, like I said earlier, it's probably energized me more than any group I've been with. You know, this has really been a fun group. So many new faces, fresh blood, and they've had a great attitude, and I'm excited about that. We've got years to go. You know, we've got miles to cover, but they've done a great job to this point.
How much have you kind of talked with Elijah, especially saying, "All right, man, you're the returning starter that we have." You know, there's a leadership role that probably comes with that.
A lot. We've spent a lot of time talking. You know, and him embracing his leadership role as a guy that was one of our, if not our leading scorer, one of our leading scorers, and played a lot as a junior transfer. And again, as I kind of referenced, my big selling point for him is how good he can be, because he really hadn't been in our development program because he kind of just stopped on campus late last August when fall semester started. So now he's taking advantage of, again, strength and conditioning, skill development, and I think he's got so much room to improve. I think it's going to be, you know, and then obviously day in and day out, he's had good habits in terms of being a really good leader.
And with Kareem, I was talking with him, that was a pretty big 180 that in your life that you had to deal with, some guys shrink away. He never did. How proud are you that he was able to?
I was really proud of him. You know what I mean? And when you go into those situations, sometimes you know ahead of time that a kid's not going to make it. You know, Ryan, in all honesty, we probably knew he wasn't going to be a qualifier, and it happened. Kareem's, you know, we had every, you know, I hate to say it, it pains me to keep telling you, we had every expectation that he was going to qualify. And, obviously we went right up to the beginning of the start of games before we kind of knew for sure. So that was different, you know what I mean? And then for that to be taken away from him at that point, you know what I mean? But he handled it really well. I think him and Taylor, to our knowledge, from the people that were able to work with those guys day in and day out last year, they worked harder than any guys that have sat out under the rules. They've invested more time than anybody we've had before. So I think that says a lot about their character and how they approach that sit-out season.
Elijah, earlier in his leadership roles, where do you feel he has to grow more as a leader for this team?
He's got to control his emotions. He's got to continue to expand his game. And a guy that he has to be able to point guys in the right direction. You know what I mean? Because things can go, not everything's going to go well at times. When things start to hit, kind of spiral a little bit, he's got to be a guy we lean on amongst a couple other older guys.
Taylor's game. You know, I've heard so much about he can do a little bit of everything. What's the best aspect of his game?
His versatility. You know, you can move him around. Offensively, he's very gifted. He's going to have to adjust mostly. I think on the defensive end of the floor is going to be where his biggest adjustments are. But he's very gifted offensively. The game comes sometimes easy to him. He's versatile. You can move him around. He's kind of a hybrid combo forward. We'll move him there, here and there. He can shoot it and stretch you out as a forward. He puts it on the floor in mismatch situations. So, his versatility is probably what excites me the most.
Ball handling skills too, right? Yeah. I mean, he's a guy that, at times last year when guards were having trouble, you had to have Dennis bring it up a little bit.
Yeah, we had time. So we're going to be much more skilled, versatile in our makeup of our team right now in terms of how our personnel makeup allows us to be more versatile, more skilled.
Heard the word versatile quite a bit today from the guys, for you, is the help.
That was recruiting. That was recruiting. That's an emphasis on recruiting. We've been big. We've been big the last couple of years. I don't know if we've been as skilled maybe as we would have liked to be, as versatile. We've recruited that way. When you look at the guys that we talked about, you look at a Taylor, a Pittman, Sean Smith, Gord, they kind of are very similar in their makeup, and I play with two of those guys on the floor at the same time at the forward positions. I think that's going to create some opportunities for us.